Good morning, students. In previous class, we have discussed about root and different types of root systems and functions of roots. Now we are discussing about the important part of the plant is stem. Stem is the main axis of the root system. Root system contains stem, leaves, flowers and fruits. These are the parts present in root system. Root system consists of stem, leaves, flowers and fruits. What is meant by root system? Root system is the aerial part of the plant body above the ground. Root system is the aerial part of the plant body above the ground is known as root system. Root system contains different parts like stem, leaves, flowers, fruits, etc. Stem is the main axis of the root system. Stem has nodes or internodes. Internodes where the leaves or buds arise from a point. This point is known as node. Between the two successive nodes there is internodes are present. See children, this is stem. This part is known as node. In this part, leaves and flower buds, flowers, etc. arise. Between these gap is known as internode. Between two successive nodes, the gap is known as internode. Okay, children, internode. So, first of all, we will conduct one important activity: conduction of water by stem. This is one of the activities. So, first of all, we can conduct this activity. We can write aim. What is the aim of this activity? To observe conduction of water by stem. We can do this activity. We require some materials or apparatus. So materials. What are the materials needed? A beaker. A glass of water. Come on. C few drops of red ink, and a wing of balsam plant, these are the materials required for do this activity. What are the materials required? A beaker, a glass of water, few drops of red color ink, and a twig of balsam plant. So, and then procedure. What is the procedure? First of all, we take one beaker. In this beaker, we take a glass of water. Then we add few drops of red ink with the help of ink pillar. So this is red color ink. So the water is turned into red color. Then we place a twig of balsam plant in the water with red ink. So this is balsam plant. Then we put the twig of balsam plant in the water with red ink. What can we observe? On the stem of the balsam plant, we can see a red color stripe. Because in this activity, the stem absorbs water and red color ink present in the water, then it can be transported upward of the plant. So the twig of the balsam plant, stem of the balsam plant, is turned into reddish in color. Okay. So we can observe that the stem of the balsam plant is turned into reddish in color due to the transport of water and red color ink to upward the plant. Okay. So we can conclude that stems of the plants absorb water and minerals present in the ground through roots, and it can be transported through upper part of the plant. Okay. So next one, functions of the stem. What are the functions of the stem? Stem supports the branches, leaves, flowers, and fruits. Stem gives support to branches of the plant, leaves, flowers, and fruits. Stem also transport water and minerals from root to upper part of the plant. Stem also transport food materials from leaves to lower part of the plant. In some plants, stems also store different types of food materials in the stem. Do you know, children? In some types of plants, the food materials are stored in the stem. Best example is potato, ginger, garlic, turmeric, etc. In these plants, the food material is stored in stem. So these stems are known as modified stems. Modified stems are tuberous stems. In tuberous stems, the food material is stored in the stem. So these are known as modified stems or tuberous stems. What are the examples of tuberous stems? Potato, ginger, turmeric, garlic, and sugar cane. These are the examples of modified stems. Okay, children. In next class, we will continue the another important topic, leaf. Leaves are the another important plant parts present in the plant. Okay? Thank you.